three quarterbacks I'm going to look to trade this week going into week 9. And the first guy is Josh Allen of the Buffalo Bills. The last 3 weeks, 4 weeks, I should say, Allen, he just hasn't been putting up the numbers now. He was putting up 35 to 45 point games in the first 4 weeks of the season. And then since week 5, the numbers have gone down for Allen. 20 points he had in week 5. Then week 6, he had 19. Week 7 in a plus matchup versus the Jets, he had 16. And then this week, Allen, 12.5 points. So Josh Allen, he's just not getting the job done. His value's definitely dropping as we speak, even though he's had a good year with points. But that was all the first 4 games. So now the last 4 games for Allen, he's putting up numbers that a guy you could get off waivers is doing. So right now, I'd rather trade Allen, and I could pick up a decent quarterback off waivers. Like I said, I got the waiver wire videos up. So check that out if you didn't see it, because you could get one of these guys on waivers coming into next week instead of Allen, and maybe get a running back or receiver. So like I said, I don't see things looking up really for Allen from here. The league caught on to him a little. This year, he has 4 games over 300 yards, which he never did until coming into this season. So it might have been a little bit of a fluke. And now, yeah, week 9, he's got a great matchup versus Seattle. But after that, he's got Arizona and then a bye. So Josh Allen, I don't think he's going to get the job done like he was in the beginning of the year. And if you could still sell him off for some goods out there at the quarterback position for a receiver or running back, you do that in a heartbeat. The second guy's Ryan Tannehill, who's just putting up mediocre numbers of late also after having a couple big ball games in the year. But now in his last 2, he's putting up 20 points. Is Ryan Tannehill, and he hasn't looked that great. Yesterday versus a Cincinnati team, he put up a mediocre line with 230 yards passing, 2 touchdowns and intro, and he gave you 20 yards on the ground. And the thing is, he's got the Bears coming up in week 9, and he's got Derrick Henry in the backfield. And I could see this offense go to the point like they did last year in the playoffs, where they rode Henry and Tannehill was throwing the ball 20-25 times, and they might go back to that formula is the Tennessee Titans, since they lost their last 2 games in a row, and go run heavy now as the winter months come on. And we've seen that the last 2 seasons where Derrick Henry, he's getting 30-35 carries a game as the colder months come on. So I could see that happening. So go out there and try to get something good for Tannehill, or even something decent. There's a bunch of quarterbacks on the free agent list you could pick up and put up similar numbers to Tannehill has, like he has in the last few weeks. And the third and final guy is Drew Brees. I know every week I either have him in a sell-off or a bench thing, but the thing with Brees, he's still not throwing the ball strong. If it wasn't for Alvin Kamara, his numbers would be totally horrible. But Brees versus a good Chicago defense without his top 2 receivers in Thomas and Sanders, had a good game, 280 yards and 2 touchdowns for 23 fantasy points, is Drew Brees. But the thing with him, the schedule, it's going to get a little bit tougher coming up with Tampa and San Francisco. I don't know if Michael Thomas is ever going to play this year, to be honest. He's just looking like a guy that made his money for the teammate, and he's not even having a desire to play. So the thing with Brees, he's not going to get you the rushing yards. He's got a bad arm. So if teams figure him out a way to stop Kamara, they're going to stop Brees well, because most of these yards are coming off yards after catch from his receivers. So Drew Brees, I would sell him high. He's had 3 in a row good games after struggling a little early in the year. So go out there and sell Brees. So that's 3 quarterbacks I'm going to look to trade and sell going into week 9.